Ladies and gentlemen, the beauties of Necrensis, best described by the music of Bacolod Soldiers.
You're the one for me, you're my ecstasy, you're the one I need.
Yeah, we're gonna be set and dance. Good evening, everyone. Yeah, yeah. Say what?
You're the one for me. You're my ecstasy. You're the one.
Come on.
Isa sa yung unpa ang bilugan na siyo. Sa tanang niya tiniun simulang isa iyapo. Kapuling aloyo inday. Ikaw ay kauban sa kalisod ko galipay. Occidental na oriental. Tapos wala ka paris kag espesyal. Kung ako sa imo, tinalaga kong alaba. Basta we're together, matuda forever.
You're
the one for me. Mangilala kay base patani ka shendera la usa ka katos ka hektarya ug sentral di aso karera shamboy herdera matamis na yuhu
come on come on
kalampay ang mata mo masunod big sham big baby kung ikaw masiplatan perte ang ibang
hey
papatsaga mo matod you're the one for me you're my ecstasy you're the one I need mulido alamara clara pero halo ko mga tiglubi pa si Gabriela
pinasa
Magduwa-duwa matamis pa sa kalamay. Magpaganda sa akong nga mata. Ikaw lang ang mata humang
huming
ang babae na ako na ginahando. Mas kita mo may pila
sa inyong mga lalas.
Sa ikaw na
tumatya
sa
akong
palaga. You're the one for me.
Say what?
You're my ecstasy. You're the one for me. You're the one for me. You're my ecstasy.
Look, everyone.
Yeah.
Okay, Pride.
Beauty, poise, and elegance are ladies in their evening gown, starting with Miss San Carlos.
Blanche Santa Maria from San Carlos City is wearing an evening ensemble rich in earthly splendor of golden shades in terracotta and hammered gold, translated into an off-shoulder cut in a body-conscious silhouette, evoking a fusion of art and fashion as the creation is embellished with classical decorative details, highlighted by scintillating crystals and diamante beadworks. Ladies and gentlemen, from San Carlos City, Miss Blanche Santa Maria.
Thank you.
Number 2 from Kabantalan City is April Rose Sevier is wearing a creation of Jerry Hernandez in a bloody red creation crafted with stretchable fabric in a lifted body silhouette with plunging neckline and highlighted with long center high slit and floor sweeping crew. The ensemble is accentuated by multi-dimensional crystal and rhinestones. Once again from Kabantalan City, Miss April Rose Javier. From the municipality of Murcia, Miss Rhea Banginaon is wearing a sweetheart cut serpentine gown with front slit. The bronze sequin ensemble is embellished with Japanese gold cut beads to emphasize the body contour. Once again, candidate number 3, Miss Rhea Banginaon. Number 4, Trixie Ong from Lakar Lotus City is wearing a gown which is embellished with Swarovski stones contemplated with a soft tulle that makes it very flowy. The gold evening gown represents grace, elegance, and royalty and is designed by Bong Bong Florist. Trixie Ong. Number 5 from the municipality of Cebulan, Miss Marvy Face Juarez is wearing an elegantly cut in the most body-conscious silhouette, wherein the ensemble features a plunging bustier neckline adorned with semi-precious emerald green crystals and a see-through serpentina sequin skirt, which features intricate patterns and highlights a modern classic inspiration which befits an empowered Negrense woman. Designed by Ding Dong Ang and executed by Mr. Jerry Hernandez. Once again, candidate number 5, Miss Marvy Faye Suarez. Number 6 is from the city of gentle people, Miss Marie Faustine Sindyong, wearing a flaming red long sleeve body hugging silhouette made of polychrome silk embroidery lace, showcasing Baroque symmetrical pattern, lavishly decorated with red semi-precious stones, tracing throughout the bodies that really adds to the depth needed. And perfecting the curve is a serpentine full skirt designed by Mr. Larry Ebaste. candidate number 6 for Dumaguete City, Miss Marie Faustine Simbiong. Candidate number 7 from Canlaon City is Miss Timmy Julie Kalumba. Wearing a lemon yellow form-fitting creation made of soft stretch illusion tulle in a bustier strapped with a see-through upper bodice to create a perfect figure. It is accentuated with Swarovski crystals and silver beads, cascading through the bodice, highlighted with a multi-layered floor sweeping skirt. Once again, candidate number 7, Timmy Julie Kalumba. Candidate number 8, from the municipality of San Enrique, Miss Mary Grace Tautuan. Wearing a creation designed by Tanette Perdon, a translation of modern environmental greenery view with linear pattern made through flowy grass green chiffon, encrusted emerald sequins for linear pattern, and highlighted by gold and light green applique. Once again, candidate number 8, Miss Mary Grace Tautuan. Candidate number 1 from Bayawan City, Miss May Alexandra Frisia Helmsirani. Wearing a high fashion shimmered blue evening gown crafted with multi-dimensional sequin fabric, accentuated with a see-through corset in full parade of body bones, accented with the applications of crystal bamboo beads and different sizes of rhinestones and intricate beadworks. Once again, candidate number 9, Miss May Alexandra Krisha Hamsirani. Number 10 from Bacolod City, Miss Lindy Cabajo. Wearing a gown made of Aleutian tulle and Thailand sequin fabric, accentuated with French lace and embellished with Japanese bugle bars, cut beads, and imported crystals to look more radiant and fabulous, fitted for a queen. Once again, candidate number 10, Miss Lindy Cabajo. Candidate number 11 from the municipality of Pontevedra is Miss Chinchin Gores. Wearing an off-white serpentina gown made of silk tulle material, wherein the evening apparel features an embroidery in modern geometric line, embellished with beads and crystals, designed by Mr. John Diching. Number 11, Miss Chinchin Gales. candidate number 12 from the municipality of La Castellana, Miss Kimberly Tanique. Wearing a gown designed by Miss Ariel Apoyan, this Tanzanite jewel-colored gown creates sexiness and drama that exudes beauty and glamour. It is made of stretched spandex accentuated with the glittering baroque appliques of imported lace material patterned intricately at the back. Once again, from the municipality of La Castellana, Miss Kimberly Tanique. Number 13 from Talisay City is Miss Renzi Jeka Jimenea. Wearing a serpentina cut made of see-through fabricated embroidery in green ostrich-colored gown with gold crystal stones, stuffed or cuffed long sleeve, plump and embellished with green gemstones and ostrich feathers designed by Miss Michelle Hetchanova. Once again, candidate number 13, Miss Renzi Jeka Jimenea. Ladies and gentlemen, our candidate number 14, Miss Jaya Mapa, wearing a gown that is inspired from the color of the ocean. The ocean blue apparel in serpentine silhouette is fully hand-beaded in silver, aqua, and royal blue. Once again, candidate number 14, Miss Jaya Mapa. Municipality of Ayuan, candidate number 15, Miss Gian Althea Hermudo. Wearing a creation by Melchi Tevez from the state-of-the-art material, the green topaz neoprene. The fabric is ingeniously cut into a multi-panel body-skimming silhouette, gradually blossoming with a flare hemline. Dramatic is the most aristocratic shade of green topaz, and defined with a galaxy of crystals and gems, lavishly creating a Byzantine drama as it sparkles with a contemporary glitz, glamour, and bedazzlement. Once again, candidate number 15, Miss Gian Althea Hermudo. Thank you.
evening gown competition. This is another test for these women to prove that they have the right character of being a true queen, that in spite of chaos, they can still be composed and remain beautiful and elegant. That's why all the candidates, congratulations again for doing a great job. All right, I know everyone is pretty much excited. We'll be giving out another set of awards. Just to give you a sneak preview, may arapata corporate awards, and I have three. One would be Miss Menzi. Mercy, that is. Miss Mercy 2016, that's one of the corporate awards. Miss CL Pito Pito, and Miss Mega World's Most Stunning Beauty Award. Excited? Excited, syempre. Ako ganun excited na. Let's do call Miss Mercy 2016 first. Miss Mercy 2016 is candidate number 6, Dumaguete, Marie Faustine Sinjong.
To present the award for Miss Mercy, let's welcome Miss Femi Magbanua. And Miss Mercy will receive 5,000 pesos.
Photo ops. All right, thank you very much. Ms. Dumaguete is Miss Mercy 2016. Next corporate award, Miss CL Pito Pito. All right, here you go. Miss CL Pito Pito goes to candidate number 3. Musha!
To present the award for Miss CL Pito Pito,
Miss Rhea Baginaon.
Let's welcome Mr. Aisped Montecalvo and Mr. Jomarie Tribusha. And Miss CL Pito Pito will receive a cash of 5,000 pesos.
Thank you, candidate number 3. To complete the corporate awards, let's give out Miss Mega World's Most Stunning Beauty Award. And that is candidate number... Sino? No, lapit, lapit. Candidate number 7, Calaon City, Timmy Julie Kalumba.
To present the award for Most Stunning Beauty Award of Mega World, let's welcome Mr. Rowley Brill and Miss Christina Magbuhos. And Miss Most Stunning Beauty Award will receive a sash, a bouquet, a plaque, and a cash of 5,000 pesos.
There you have it, Miss Mega World's Most Stunning Beauty Award. Now that completes our corporate awards with Miss Mercy 2016 Miss CL Pito Pito and Mega World's Miss Stunning Beauty Award. Now, let's move on to the candidate that bested all others in her one-of-a-kind talent. Ang pinaka-pinasahi sa tanan ng talento. Ang best talent. All right. The award goes to... Best talent is candidate number 8. Municipality of San Enrique, Mary Grace Tautuan.
To present the award for Best in Talent, let's welcome SP member Miguel Zaico and Kabangkalan Sinulog Foundation Board of Director, Barangay Captain Ray Cordero. Best in Talent will receive a cash.
Will be given to the candidate who was able to win all other candidates' hearts because of her friendliness and good-natured personality. This award was voted by the candidates themselves. Sila sila mismo ang nagboto sa kay Miss Congeniality or Miss Friendship. Miss Congeniality goes to... Kabangkalan City, April Rose Javier.
To receive the award, let's welcome SP member Rodrigo Cadigal and SP member George Largado. And Miss Congeniality will receive a cash award.
Of them all, candidate number 2 from Kabangkalan City. Congratulations. Next, of course, as they are all here in their gown, this award is for the lady who stood out regally in her evening gown. Best evening gown award goes to Miss Miss Ayumon, candidate number 15, Gian Althea Hermudo.
To present the award for Best in Gown, let's welcome SP member Rodica Mangao and Kabangkalan Sinulog Board of Director John Peter Milan. And Best in Gown will receive a cash award.
Wow. So far, so good. The awards have been given out, from the corporate awards to the minor awards. Siguro by this time, may ara na kamo kandidata ninyo, no? To be the one Negros Island Region Queen. Soon enough, mabalaan ta na. Ayumon, candidate number 15. A big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Palakpakan ta sila tanan, mga kapamilya. Again, I would like to congratulate the new set of special award winners. And we are getting nearer, as I've said, to the one Negros Island Queen 2016. The fact that you are here representing your city or your municipality is already a big chance for all of you. All right, that's why you will all be serenaded by a special guest. Straight from the Voice of the Philippines Season 1, Team Bamboo, a certified recording artist and Awit Awards Best New Male Recording Artist, currently promoting his debut album, Pop Go Standards. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up to Paolo Onesa! Thank you.
make you happy, make your dreams come true. Said there is nothing that I wouldn't do. Go to the ends of the earth for you, to make you feel my love, to make you feel my love.
How's everyone doing? Okay? Enjoy. Now please do sing along with this next song, okay? Huh? My name again is Paulo Nessa. Hope you guys enjoy this next song. Let's do this. This song is dedicated to the candidates, which are so beautiful tonight. And this just song just describes them. So here we go. May nakita ko mga magaganda, oh. Saan?
My life is brilliant. My love is pure. I saw that angel. Of that I'm sure. You smiled at me on the subway, but you were with another man. But I won't lose no sleep on that, 'cause I've got a plan.
You see?
You're beautiful, it's true. I saw your face in this crowded place, and I don't know what to do, 'cause I will never be with you. See from my face that I was flying high, and I don't think that I'll see you again. But we share this moment that will last till the end. You're beautiful, you are beautiful. You're beautiful, it's true.
Smile on her face when she thought that I should be with you.
Oh, yeah. Now it's time to face the truth that I will never be with you. Yeah.
Thank you. My name is Paulo Nessa, and I'll see you guys later again. Thank you. Thank you.
There you have it.
Yes. Thank you so much, Mr. Paulo Nessa, for that wonderful and well-deserved serenade. But right now, Alan, we are moving on, and we are moving forward with the competition. The judges have already trimmed out the selection to only 8 candidates.
Wow.
To move on to the next round.
Come take the first spot, candidate number 5 from Cebuan, K.M. Suarez.
You are also moving forward Candidate number 6, Miss Dumaguete Marie Faustine Sindio.
Still competing is candidate number 9 from Bayawan, May Alexandra Hamsirari.
It's your time to shine. Candidate number 15 from Ayuan, Miss Gian Althea Hermudo.
Take the spotlight, candidate number 8 from San Enrique, Mary Grace Moneda Tautuan.
It's time to rejoice from the city of San Carlos, candidate number 1, Miss Blanche Santa Maria.
And you are definitely in candidate number 12 from La Castellana, Kimberly Tanique.
One more spot left, and that spot goes to candidate number 2 from Kabankalan, Miss April Rose Javier. And the crowd goes wild. Ladies and gentlemen, your top 8 semifinalists.
Wow, pero ang competition na nag-start pa lang niya, Agnes. It's not yet over, ladies and gentlemen, because these 8 ladies will now face the most challenging part of the competition.
Yes, that nerve-wracking part will test their spontaneity and should be able to really think quick. Let us start with candidate number 5. Yes, candidate number 5, Miss Cebulan. Ladies and gentlemen, we will have a bowl with the name of our judges,
yeah,
and our
judges
candidates
from 1 to 5.
We'll pick one judge who will give them their question for tonight. Hi, candidate number 5, how are you feeling now that you made it to the top 8?
Hello, good evening, everyone. Well, right now I feel so deeply privileged and honored to be part of this pageant, this very prestigious pageant. And I'm out of words. I really can't believe that I was part of the top 8. Very unexpected.
One step closer to the crown.
All right.
I believe she is ready to pick her judge for tonight.
Just from judge 1 to 5.
Can we have our bowl? Okay, let's carry on.
May arata sang ano eh, sang bowl kung diin ikwaon yung number, no?
While waiting, candidate number 5, would you like to say a little something to your supporters tonight who are here?
Well, I only have our local chief executive and his officials, and also my mother here with me, and also to my handler, Tita Ding Dong, and my makeup artist, Joella. Thank you so much. My classmates and my friends and the rest of my family, of the family members weren't able to come here to support me, but I know that they have prayed me and they are really supportive in me.
Wow, okay. Behind every beauty queen, there is a very supportive mother behind her.
And this one, ang ilaya nga mayor, ang ilahang mayor from Cebulan, ha? Wow,
yan
very supportive, kaayong bita.
Okay.
All right.
Let
candidate,
take a judge.
Please take a number.
Candidate number 5 has chosen Mr. Manuel Canson.
That's our first judge, Agnes. So Mr. Manuel Manda Canson.
Okay. Good evening, Miss Number 5.
Good evening, sir.
Here's my question. What makes a beautiful woman like you happy? Again, what makes a beautiful woman like you happy?
What makes a beautiful woman like me happy is optimism. I always maintain a positive outlook in life. No matter the circumstances, I always choose to be happy. And the two sides of the coin, I always look at the lighter side. In fact, My motto in life is always see a glass half full rather than half empty. Thank you.
Wow, very well said.
Yes, very well said. Thank you so much, candidate number five.
From Cebulan, Faye Suarez. But remember, ang glass is refillable.
Exactly, Alan.
So it's not half full or half empty.
It depends on the drink, you know.
Tekita mo na.
Because those drinks that come with a price.
Oh, bottomless.
Yes.
All right, next is candidate number six from Dumaguete, Marie Faustine Sinjong.
Marie, you bagged most of our special and corporate awards tonight. How are you feeling with that?
I'm really feeling happy right now because I did not really expect to bag most of the awards, and now I just really feel happy and nervous at the same time.
Unsa man di ay, you know, gihakot almost.
Hakot awards.
Oh, hakot awards.
So are you now ready to pick on your judge?
Miss Dumaguete.
And she has chosen Mr. Rafael Niera.
Good evening, candidate number six.
Good evening, sir.
This is my question. Someday, or one day when you marry, who will you choose? A guy who is extremely handsome but not rich? Or a guy who is not handsome but rich? I will repeat the question. When you marry someday, what or who will you choose? A guy who is handsome but not rich? Or a guy that is not handsome but rich?
You know, if you really love someone, it would not really matter if he's rich or he's handsome, as long as you both love each other and your love is genuine. But of course, to be practical and to answer that question, I would say the guy who is not handsome but with money.
Technology.
What is your take on that, Alan?
What can technology do? If you are not handsome but you're rich, my plastic surgery.
And I think, you know,
magwala na galing sa offspring.
Oh, gani man. Pero kaya offspring, pwede mo man na siya mapa-undergo plastic surgery pag nako niya.
Ay, kita mo lang git. Alright, that's from Miss Dumaguete, candidate number 6. Next is candidate number 9 from Bayawan, May Alexandra Hamsirani. Wow. Don't tongue twister to sa ako, Agnes. Hello. How are you?
I'm good, and I'm very happy that I'm part of the top 8.
All right, there you go. Miss Hamsirani from Bayawan.
Okay, let's go ahead and pick your judge.
Ang Bayawan, may lakot na Ilonggo and Visayas.
Ako, I haven't been there yet. Wala ko pa na na-discover.
Very productive place. All right, this time, the question will be coming from Mr. Andrew Wolf.
Good evening.
Good evening to sir.
By the way, I'm not rich.
It's okay, it doesn't matter.
Okay, so here's your question. Okay, so what would you do if, say, one of the judges awarded you the winner of this pageant, and then a few minutes later they come out and say, actually, it was candidate number 5. What would you do?
Well, honestly, it happened to me. I was given two awards, and then minutes before they announced the major awards, they took it off because they told me that they gave the award to the wrong person. Well, honestly, the feeling is not good. It's somehow embarrassing, but what I did is I took off the sash personally, and I wanted to give it to the right candidate, but they don't want it to. Well, as a beauty queen, I know that that would probably be the worst scenario, but what you should do is just show what a true beauty queen you are and just compose yourself and smile and feel beautiful because you are.
Thank you very much.
Confidently beautiful
yes,
with a heart.
Yes, Fire 1, candidate number 9. At the end of the day, Agnes, it's composure, huh?
And at the end of the day, they are all considered as the winners anyway.
True enough. True enough. And that is why they are here. And that is why there's only 8 of them left.
Exactly.
That's why we'll call on Miss Ayungon, candidate number 15, Jan Althea Hermudo. Have you ever experienced that, Agnes? You had the crown, or you had the sash.
No, I haven't.
Or you had the trophy.
Not yet.
Good for you. Good for you. But I could just imagine, no? Budlay siguro, ha?
I don't think it would be that difficult, you know. Because if you're happy for your fellow candidates, then it wouldn't really be that heavy. You would be happy for them. They'd be happy for you. At the end of the day, it's a good show.
Hello, Miss Ayungon.
Hello.
All right, good.
You have a very lovely gown, by the way.
Very beautiful.
It's my favorite color.
All right. Wow. Is that your birthstone? They usually, mga birthstones mo ang color, you know?
Again, the judge chosen is Mr. Manuel Canson.
All right. Mabakal si Mr. Canson subong magabi.
Okay. Here's my question. How does joining pageants like this help you as a person? Again, how does joining pageants like this help you as a person?
Okay, thank you for that question, sir. First, it will give me more confidence to show who I am to other people. Whether I am ugly or not, as long as me, myself, knows that I can do everything, I know I am beautiful in front of other people. Thank you.
Very well
very
said.
Very calmly delivered.
Yes. Thank you very much, Ms. Ayungon, candidate number 15.
And let us now call on our next finalist, candidate number 8, from the municipality of San Enrique.
Mary Grace Monera Tautuan. Hello, Ms. San Enrique.
I'm fine.
Good. Very good. All right. Take your pick. Wow. Kilala mo gid ni? Amiga taman ni. The question will be coming from Ms. Sham Diatras.
Hello, candidate number 8. Good evening.
Hi, good evening too.
So here it goes. What do you think is the essence of being the Queen of Negros Island Region?
The essence of being a queen of the island region is possessing the personality of being a queen, not just having beauty, brains, but also to have morals, because without morals, beauty and brain are nothing but emptiness. Thank you.
All right, very well said. Miss San Enrique.
Yeah,
candidate number
8. Sana pa no?
Grabe, straight to the point.
Yes, brief and concise.
Wow. Queen. Next is San Carlos, candidate number 1, Blanche Santa Maria. Five down.
Three to go.
Four more to go. Three lang. Okay. Sige.
Good evening, Blanche. You have
right,
so many supporters here tonight. Would you like to take this chance to say thank you to them?
Actually, it's not really a lot of them. It's just a small of them, but they have a big heart and a big cheer. So it seems like it's a lot. So I really thank you so much for being here. They're my family. Even my handlers, I consider them as my family. Thank you so much.
Okay, good. Let's now pick a judge.
Take your pick, Miss San Carlos. Ini ano mani? Sagol pod Ilonggo og Bisaya, Miss San Carlos. Ah, no? It's Bisaya. Yud. Ah, all right. Yud.
Miss Blanche has chosen Mr. Wilfred Plasencia Jr.
Yes. All right.
Good evening, Miss San Carlos. My question is, if you were to choose between the two, would you rather be beautiful but not too smart, or smart but not too beautiful? Why?
Beauty cannot, good evening, everyone. Beauty cannot only guarantee anyone a crown. We have to be practical inside that everyone must know that we can be beautiful by the use of our brain. We have to remember that a woman can be beautiful using her brain, but a woman cannot be intelligent just by using her beautiful face. That will be all. Thank you.
There we have it.
I have to agree, Alan.
See what? If you're beautiful, ka brainy ka pa. Plus na na.
Plus na gina yun eh. Swerte ka. Kaya you have both. Just like these women tonight. They are beautiful and they are brainy.
Somebody told me, beauty is skin deep, but ugliness is bone deep. Hasta sa tulaan pag itagita ko na.
Galapos.
Alright, let's move on to candidate number 12 from La Castellana, Kimberly Taniquer.
Ito ng crowd sumuno. Ito nagahipos. May kinakulbaan na sila tanan.
Actually, kina-analyze mo nila ang mga answers sa ito ng mga candidates.
Hello, good Hello. Evening.
Hello.
How are you feeling tonight?
I'm fine.
All right, take your pick, please.
And she has chosen Mr. Rafael Leoniera.
Hello, candidate number 12.
Hello, sir.
My question goes this way. If you will be crowned tonight, what will be the very first thing that you will do and why? Again, I will repeat the question. If you will be crowned tonight, what will be the very first thing that you will do and why?
Good evening, everyone. If I will be crowned tonight, the first thing I will do is to thank Almighty God for bringing me here in this pageant, because for me, it's an honor to be a part of the top 8. Second, if I'll be crowned as a Negros Island Region Queen 2016, I will use my voice to influence others to become like me, confident, beautiful, and ready to face everyone, because I believe myself, I can conquer in any endeavor. Thank you.
There
Thank you
it.
Very much.
Candidate number 12 from La Castellana. Grabe, simple lang.
Simple
Use her
lang.
Voice.
And it's good na pagka if ever na crown siya, the first thing she will do is thank God. Di ba na hamba nila, you put God first.
Were you asked that question before? Sangga join
no.
ka pa? Ano? Or, pero if ever you'd be asked, ano yung imong first game mo?
Literally, I will cry.
Let it out.
But no, truthfully, I will also thank God and my parents,
right.
most especially for being so supportive, because before, they are against this whole pageantry.
Right. But now, they're very much happy and very much proud
Yes,
of you.
Yes, they support me all the way.
Let's complete the top 8 with Miss Kabangkalan, candidate number 2, April Rose Javier.
Miss Kabangkalan, any words for your fellow Kabangkalanons tonight?
I'm really thankful that I was chosen to represent my own city. Thank you everyone for the support. God bless.
And let us now choose your judge.
Take a pick, please.
Miss Kabangkalan has chosen Mr. Wilfred Plasencia Jr.
Good evening, Ms. Kabangkalan. My question is, among the other candidates, why should we crown you as the one Queen Negros Island Region?
Okay. You will crown me because I have strong mind, strong willpower, I have the beauty that a true Negrense has, and I have the heart to extend my help to other people. In short, I have everything that it takes to be crowned as Miss Queen of Negros Island Region. Thank you, everyone.
There we have it. The confidence.
Thank you, candidate number two from Gabang Kalahan.
I have.
Wow. surely, Agnes, the judges will really have a hard time.
A hard time, yes.
Choosing.
I myself, I'm having a hard time choosing my own top three. How much more our judges?
Pero, here's the thing. From eight, himuon na pagid ya three.
Tatlo.
Pero before that, I would like to ask everyone, would you like more entertainment? Would you like more of Paolo?
Ay, do kahinay, hinay. Again, do you want to hear more of Paolo?
Give it up for Mr.
Paolo Onessa.